Jayurada Madhava Kunja Vihari Jayurada Madhava Kunja Vihari Jayagopi Jana Vallabha Girivaradhari Jayagopi Jana Vallabha Girivaradhari Yashodanandana Vraja Jana Ranjana Yashodanandana Vraja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Teeravanachari Yamuna Teeravanachari Yamuna Teeravanachari Jayo Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivaradhari Yashodanandana Vraja Jana Ranjana Yashodanandana Vraja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Teeravanachari Yamuna Teeravanachari Yamuna Teeravanachari Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Jaya Radha Madhava Radha Madhava Radhe Jaya Radha Madhava Radha Madhava Radhe Jaya Krishna Balaram Krishna Balaram Krishna Balaram Jaya Krishna Balaram Jaya Gauranita 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 Jaya Gauranita Jaya Jaya Prabhupada 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada Javo Mishne Pada Paramahamsa Parivraja Kacharya Sotara Shata Shumadhi Swamis Abhaya Saranara Vinda Bhakti Dhandu Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jaya Javo Mishne Pada Paramahamsa Parivraja Kacharya Sotara Shata Shumadhi Swamis Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasata Kurumaharaj Prabhupada Ki Jaya Vairagya Murti Srila Gaur Kishore Dasa Babaji Maharaj Prabhupada Ki Jaya Sachidana Srila Bhakti Vinata Kurumaharaj Prabhupada Vishnu Sarvam Hasriya Jagannath Dasa Babaji Maharaj Prabhupada Ki Jaya Sri Rupa Sanatana Bhattara Vanata Shri Jeeva Gopala Bhattara Dasagana Shatko Swami Prabhupada Ki Jaya Namacharya Srila Haridasa Thakur Ki Jaya Prem Sekhav Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaura Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayam Udhirayet Nashtaprayeshu Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 2, Canto 1, Chapter number 16, Text number 1. How Parikshit received the age of Kali. Chapter name. Suta Bhuvacha Tataha Parikshit Vijavarya Sikshaya Mahi Mahabhagavataha Sakasashashaha Yatahi Shutyama Vijata Kovida Samadishan Vipra Mahat Gunastatha सूत उवाच तथा परीक्षित द्विजवर्य शिक्षया मही महाभागवतः सशाशः यता हि सूत्यामभिजात कोविदा समादिशन् विप्रमहद्गुणस्तथा सूत उवाच ततः परीक्षित द्विजवर्य शिक्षया मही महाभागवतः सा शशाशः यता हि सूत्यामभिजात कोविदा समादिशन् विप्रमहद्गुणस्तथा सूत उवाच सूत गोस्वामी से ततः देर आफ्टर परीक्षित महाराज परीक्षित द्विजवर्या द ग्रेट ट्वाइस बॉर्न ब्राह्मण शिक्षया बाय देयर इंस्ट्रक्शंस महीम द अर्थ महाभागवतः द ग्रेट डिवोटी ससास रूल्ड हा इन द पास यथा एज दे टोल्ड इट He certainly Sutyam at the time of his birth. Abhijatako Vidaha, expert astrologers at the time of birth. Samadishan gave their opinions. Vipra of Brahmanas. Mahat Gunaha, great qualities. Tatha, true to that. Translation and purport bar is to engage. A.C. Bhaktidanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Translation. Suta Goswami said, O learned Brahmanas, Maharaja Parikshit then began to rule over the world as a great devotee of the Lord under the instructions of the best of the twice born Brahmanas. He ruled by those great qualities which were foretold by expert astrologers at the time of his birth. Purport by Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. At the time of Maharaja Parikshit's birth, the expert astrologer Brahmanas foretold some of his qualities. Maharaja Parikshit developed all those qualities being a great devotee of the Lord. The real qualification is to become a devotee of the Lord and gradually all the good qualities worthy of possession develop. Maharaja Parikshit was a Mahabhagavata, the first class devotee who was not only well versed in the science of devotion but also able to convert others to become devotees by his transcendental instructions. Maharaja Parikshit was therefore a devotee of the first order and thus he used to consult great sages and learned brahmanas who could advise him by the shastras how to execute the state administration. Such great kings were more responsible than modern elected executive heads because they obliged the great authorities by following their instructions left in Vedic literature. There was no need for impractical fools to enact daily a new legislative bill and to conveniently alter it again and again to serve some purpose. The rules and regulations were already set forth by the great sages like Manu, Yajnavalkya, Parashara and other liberated sages, and the enactments were all suitable for all ages in all places. Therefore, the rules and regulations were standard and without flaw or defect. Kings like Maharaja Parikshit had their council of advisors, and all the members of the council were either great sages or brahmanas of the first order. They did not accept any salary nor had they any necessity for such salaries. The state would get the best advice without expenditure. They were themselves samadarshi, equal to everyone, both man and animal. They would not advise the king to give protection to man and instruct him to kill the poor animals. Such council members were not fools or representatives to compose a fool's paradise. They were all self-realized souls and they knew perfectly well how all living beings in the state would be happy both in this life and in the next. They were not concerned with the hedonistic philosophy of eat, drink, be merry and enjoy. They were philosophers in the real sense and they knew well what is the mission of human life. Under all these obligations, the advisory council of the king would give correct directions. And the king or executive head, being himself a qualified devotee of the Lord, would scrutinizingly follow them for the welfare of the state. The state in the days of Maharaja Yudhishthira or Maharaja Parikshit was a welfare state in the real sense of the term because no one was unhappy in that state, be he man or animal. Maharaja Parikshit was an ideal king for a welfare state of the world. Om Ajnanati Virandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Mena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namaha Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Nitinamine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyanti Sitarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Srivasadi Gaura Bhaktarunda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare Here, this chapter is, after the Pandavas have retired and Lord Krishna has disappeared, Dhritarashtra has quit his home and so Pandavas also retired themselves and they established Parikshit as the next emperor of the world. Now, having taken the responsibility of rulership, now how Parikshit is ruling the world? This is the question asked by Suta Goswami in the assembly of answer given by Suta Goswami the chapter begins with the answer by Suta Goswami O Lord of Brahmanas, Maharaja Parikshit then began to rule over the world as a great devotee of the Lord. Under the instructions of the best of the twice born Brahmanas, he ruled by those great qualities which were foretold by expert astrologers at the time of his birth. At the time of his birth, the expert astrologers foretold that this person, the Parikshit, is not an ordinary person. Is compared to great stalwart emperors has been protected by Lord Krishna in the womb of Uttara when Ashwatthama has released Brahmastra. So this child will be well known in the world as one who is protected by the personality of Godhead, the most fortunate one. There is no doubt that this child will become a first class devotee and will be qualified with all good qualities. O son of Tuta, this child shall be exactly like King Ikshvaku, son of Manu, in maintaining all those who are born. And as for following the prince grammatical principles, especially in being true to his promise, he shall be exactly like Rama, the personality of Godhead, the son of Maharaja Dasharatha. This child this child will be a munificent donor of charity and protector of the surrendered, like the famous King Sibi of the Ushinara country, and he will expand the name and family of fame of his family like Bharata, the son of Maharaja Dushyanta. Amongst great bowmen, this child will be as good as Arjuna. He will be irresistible as fire and as unsurpassable as the ocean. This child will be as strong as a lion and as worthy a shelter as the Himalaya mountains. He will be forbearing like the earth and as tolerant as his parents. This child will be like his grandfather Yudhishthira or Brahma. In equality of mind, he will be munificent like the Lord of the Kailasha Hill, Shiva, and he will be a sort of everyone, like the Supreme Personality of Godhead Narayana, who is even the shelter of the Goddess of Fortune. This child will be almost as good as Lord Sri Krishna by following in his footsteps. In magnanimity, he will be as great as King Rantideva, and in religion, he will be like Maharaja Yayati. This child will be like Bali Maharaja in patience, a staunch devotee of Lord Krishna like Prahlad Maharaja, a performer of many Ashwamedha horse sacrifices, and a follower of the old and experienced man. This child will be the father of kings who will be like sages. For world peace and for the sake of religion, he will be the chastiser of the upstarts and the quarrelsome. After hearing about his death, which will be caused by the bite of a snake bird sent by a son of a brahmana, he will get himself freed from all material attachment and surrender unto the personality of God and taking shelter of him. As we discussed, so he is compared to many, many great stalwarts. So having got the great qualities, he ruled the entire earth. At the time of Maharaja Parikshit's birth, the expert astrologer Brahmanas foretold some of his qualities. Maharaja Parikshit developed all those qualities, being a great devotee of the Lord. The real qualification is to become a devotee of the Lord. And gradually all the good qualities worthy of possession develop. Now we see outside world, material world, there are many qualities people appreciate, being clean and merciful, compassionate, truthful, austere. So they appreciate the outside world people appreciate these qualities. Here, this separately, if you try to develop these qualities, it is not so easy. But if you just become a devotee of Lord Krishna, you will develop all these qualities: truthfulness, cleanliness, mercifulness, intelligence, compassion. So many good qualities, love for all the living entities, equanimity, treating everybody equally. So many good qualities you will develop just because you become a devotee of Lord Krishna. But if you are not devotee of Lord Krishna, you can try to develop these qualities which will not be so perfect. Maharaja Parikshit was a Mahabhagavata or a first class devotee who was not only well versed in the science of devotion, but also able to convert others to become a devotee by his transcendental instructions. So Mahabhagavatas, not only they themselves become a devotee, they also convert others to devotee. Able to convert others to become devotees by his transcendental instructions. So Mahabhagavata is he able to make others devotee. That is Mahabhagavata. Maharaja Parikshit was therefore a devotee of the first order And thus he used to consult great sages and learned brahmanas who advised him by the shastras and how to execute state administration. So the society was running perfectly under the guidance of brahmanas. The king is to rule and vaishyas is to produce and shudras is to support all these categories of higher caste. So in this society was running peacefully. Now there is no qualified brahmanas, there is no qualified brahmanas giving advisory to the head of the states, executives. Since there is no qualified brahmanas, there is no advisory, the whole society is in chaotic condition because they have introduced so many laws. Every day they are introducing new laws, they are introduced diverse law, and they introduce planet introduced homosexual also, they are introducing planet introduced, and so many things every day they introduce new laws. But these are all demoniac laws, only causing disturbance to society. Maharaja Parikshit was therefore a devotee of the first order and thus used to consult great sages and learned brahmanas. Those who do not follow scriptural injunction, they are like demons. So this present situation is do not follow any scriptural injunction. So that is why all chaotic condition is happening. And brahmanas, they are qualified, they are very peaceful, they are very truthful, clean, compassion. So many austere, so many qualities these brahmanas they have. And they used to advise, they are not greedy also, they are not lusty, greedy, angry. They are very sober, peaceful, sattva-guna brahmanas. And they used to advise by the shastras how to execute state administration. Such great kings were more responsible than modern elected executive. Such great kings were more responsible than modern elected executive heads because they were obliged to the great authorities by following their instructions left in Vedic literature. So the responsibility of a king, a responsibility of a father, mother, responsibility of a guru is that he should make sure that the dependents, the prajas, they engage in their life in spiritual development. That is the main objective of giving the leadership position. One should not become father, mother, guru, husband if he has to deliver his dependents from the repeated birth and death. So this is the responsibility of the king and responsibility of all the executive heads of the state and the father, mother, guru to deliver their dependents. The leader should follow the instructions of the great sages and the Vedic literatures, and they should encourage all the other dependents to follow these instructions. There was no need for impractical fools to enact daily a new legislative bill and to conveniently alter it again and again to serve some purpose. Now they are introducing so many laws every week, every month, and they are altering it again, amending it, and again they will alter, they will pass another law, again they will alter, again they will pass another law, again they will part, they will amend it. So this is going on like a childish play. The rules and regulations were already set forth by great sages like Manu, Yajnavalkya, Parashara and other great sages. And the enactments were all suitable for all ages in all places. Therefore, the rules and regulations were standard and without flaw or defect. So, the rules and regulations were already set forth by great sages like Manu, Yajnavalkya, Parashara and liberty sages. So, the rules given by the experienced sages like Manu, Yajnavalkya, Parashara and other liberal sages are all suitable for all ages in all places. Therefore, the rules and regulations were standard without any flaw or defect. So, this if you just follow this law, then we can avoid so many problems in this world. It is said that women should not be given any education, women should not be given any freedom, women is not supposed to be sent to Gurukula, but nowadays the women has been sent to Gurukula schools and they are freely mixing with all kinds of men. Women should not be given freedom, she should be always under the care of father, husband and sons, and so many rules. There is no question of divorce, and widow also they were not used to marry. So many laws. And now Kali Yuga, they misuse the Shastras, so that has been rejected. Because some people have misused the religion and Shastras, they have rejected all these laws of Manu, and they started their own laws, which promotes divorce, which promotes illicit sex, which promotes meat eating and gambling, intoxication. So all these things have been introduced. Kings like Maharaja Parikshit, as their council of advisors and all the members of their council, were either great sages or brahmanas of the first order. They did not accept any salary, nor had any necessity for such salaries. So brahmanas means they never accept any salary, they never accept any job. So they just give advice as per the Shastras. State would get the best advice from without expenditure. They were themselves samadarshi, equal to everyone, both man and animal. They would not advise the king to give protection to the man and instruct him to kill the poor animal. Such council members were not fools or representatives to compose a fool's paradise. So praja means those who are taken birth in a particular place, they are called prajas. So in that way, everybody should be given equal treatment. So they will not advise kings to give protection to man and instruct him to kill the poor animals. Nowadays they have introduced so many laws that you can kill animals if it is old or it is not giving milk or something like that. So they give advice to kill animals. So they also deforest, they remove the trees in the forest, and because of the removing of so many trees in the forest and the village and in the cities, there is so much heat is generated because these trees used to consume the heat and release the oxygen. They used to consume the carbon dioxide and release the oxygen. And because of trees, the climate would be in very cold climate, and because the trees have been removed, the cities has been increased, there is a climate increase in the cities. So they are killing so many animals, so they are uprooting the trees, and they are creating a hellish condition in cities. Such council members were not fools or representatives to compose a fool's paradise. They were all self-realized souls, and they knew perfectly well how all living beings in the Osset would be happy. So such council members were not fools or representatives to compose a fool's paradise. Nowadays you see all the MLA, MPs, they are all either they are criminal convicts or criminals themselves, or they have served imprisonment, or if you see they have a criminal background. Such people are elected to the post of MLA, MP, and sometimes they are also elected to the post of Chief Minister and Prime Minister. The council members during the Parikshit Maharaj's time, they were all self-realized souls, and they knew perfectly well how all living beings in the world state would be happy, both in this life and in the next. So because all the great realized souls, they follow the injunctions of scriptural injunctions, and they know what is the purpose of this life and how to execute the injunction of Shastras in this life so that we can live happily in our next life and go back to God and spiritual world. They were not concerned with the hedonistic philosophy of eat, drink, be merry and enjoy. So such council members, they were not giving importance to enjoy life, eat, drink, be merry and enjoy life. They were philosophers in real sense and they knew well that what is the mission of human life. So they were all concerned, they were all very responsible that the mission of human life is greater, that we have to realize one's own self, Atma Tattva. So they were all, so since we have, you know what is the mission of human life, since now we know what is the goal of life, so we all have to work according to that goal. So these philosophers, the council members, were all advising all the executive heads to follow this scripture injunction and let go, walk towards the mission of human life. Mold everything, every activity in order to reach the goal of human life. You work, you eat, you beget children, you give charity, everything, you perform austerity, everything you do, you should do it in order to achieve the aim of human life. That is going back to Godhead and realizing oneself and realizing one's position with respect to God. Under all these obligations, the advisory council of the king would give correct directions, and the king or executive head, being himself a qualified devotee of the Lord, would scrutinize him for them for the welfare of the state. So the executive heads, the kings who used to follow the acharyas, the brahmanas, and they will follow, and besides that, because these people, they follow the scripture injunctions and people will be happy. They are actually real way they are actually giving benefit to the people. They are the real welfare workers. The devotees, the Narapatis, the Narendras, because they follow the instructions of the sages, the Brahmanas. The state of the days of Maharaja Dhrishtira and Maharaja Parikshit was the welfare state in the real sense of the term, because no one was unhappy in that state, be he man, animal. Maharaja Parikshit was a king of ideal king for a welfare state of the world. So during the time of Maharaja Yudhishthira and Parikshit, and nobody was unhappy, and be he a man or animal, it is said that during the time of Maharaja Parikshit, Maharaja Yudhishthira, Emperor Yudhishthira, during Emperor Yudhishthira administered generously to everyone during his reign. He was exactly like his father. He had no personal ambition and was freed from all sorts of sense gratification because of his continuous service of the lotus feet of Lord Sri Krishna. News even reached the celestial planets about Maharaja Yudhishthira's worldly possession, the sacrifices which he would attain by his decision, his queen, his starved brothers, his extensive land, his sovereignty over the planet Earth, and his fame. O Brahmanas, the opulence of the king was so enchanting that the denizens of heaven aspired for it. But because he was absorbed in the service of the Lord, nothing could satisfy him except the Lord's service. So, Parikshit Maharaja's time, everything was very nicely going. There were sufficient rains, nobody was unhappy. All the rivers are flowing and there are seasons were timely, and there was a rainy season. Everything was systematically happening. So this is a pious rule. We'll stop.